Hello students, welcome to this online course of hydraulics engineering. So in the previous lecture we have seen what will be the parameters of a most efficient channel. So we have seen the three different channels. First was the rectangular channel, second was the triangular channel, and the third one was the trapezoidal channel. The section we have discussed basically. So today we are going to apply those concepts and we will try to solve the problem based on the most economical section concept. So this is the question based on that concept. So we have to determine the most economical section of a rectangular channel carrying water at a rate of 0.5 meter cube per second. The bed slope of the channel is being 1 in 2000. Take Chagee's constant C is equal to 50. So we have to determine the most economical rectangular channel. So Q is given to us, that is 0.5 meter cube per second, C is 50, and S is given as 1 by 2000. So with the help of these parameters we have to calculate the channel section dimensions. So what we can do, we can calculate the velocity, I think, and from that velocity Q is given. Q will be the area will be Q by V. From area formula we can calculate the various parameters. So let us see how we are going to do that. So we are assuming the bed width of the rectangular channel is capital B and the depth of flow is Y. So the area of cross section will become 2y square, because for the most economical section B is equal to 2 into y. B is the bed width and it has to be 2 times of the depth of flow for most economical section. Also for also for most economical rectangular section the hydraulic radius will be half the depth of the flow, that is y by 2. So discharge can be given as area into velocity. Area is capital A. Velocity is given by the Chagee's formula, that is C root RS. So everything we are having, we have calculated area in terms of Y. C is given to us. Here S is known and Y is unknown. So after solving this equation, because Q is given to us, that is 0.5 meter cube per second. So after solving all the values, we are getting y raised to power 5 by 2 is equal to 0.3162. So y will be 0.3162 raised to power 2 by 5, that is 0.63 meters. Then the corresponding bed width will be 2 times of this value, that is 1.26. hence for most economical rectangular channel for a given condition, that is with the Q was given, the slope is given, the depth of flow is 0.63 meters, and the width of the bed width is 1.26 meters respectively. So in this manner you can solve the problems based on this concept. Now let us see the next question, which is an open channel of most economical trapezoidal section is required. So it is given in the question that the section is most economical and it is trapezoidal section. Discharge is given 20.2 meter cube per second of water. The slope of the channel bottom is 1 in 2500. Chagee's constant is given as C is 60. Determine the dimensions of the cross section. So again we will assume the section, the depth of flow Y, the side slope 1 by M. With the help of this we can calculate the top width, that will be 2B plus 2MY, and after converting all the values in terms of Y or M, we can easily calculate the dimensions. So let us see how we are going to do that. So for most economical section, trapezoidal section, the hydraulic radius has come like Y by 2. For rectangular channel and for trapezoidal section it was Y by 2, and for triangular section it was Y by 2 root 2. So hydraulic radius is given to us. Side slope is M, that is 1 by tan theta, that is 1 by root 3. So these we have taken from directly from the equations which we have derived in the previous lecture. and half of the top width will be one side of the side sloping side. So from here also we can get b is equal to 2 by root 3 into y. So b we have calculated, m this is b plus 2my, so area we can calculate. Area perimeter AR is given to us by using this. Discharge is also given to us. We can calculate y, and with the help of y the different other parameters can be determined. So area of flow is b plus my into y. B is, we have calculated 2 by root 3 into y. M is 1 by root 3, so area is root 3 into y square. Weighted perimeter is 6 by root 3 into y. Hydraulic radius, we have seen that it is coming y by 2. So discharge can be given by this formula, area into velocity. Velocity can be given by the chassis constant, that is A into C root RS, because velocity C is given, so we will be using chassis constant only, chassis equation only. So area root 3 into y square, C is 60, R is y by 2, S is 1 by 25, and it is given in the question. So Q is coming out to be 1.47 y raised to power 5 by 2. So after solving this equation, we are getting y is equal to 2.85, and the base width is coming out to be b is equal to 3.29. So we can calculate the various parameter. We have calculated y, b side length also we can calculate. So in this manner we can solve these types of questions. So this is all for today. The next few more questions we are going to see in the next class. So this is all for today. Thank you.